AI is quite a difficult term because it means three different things. So the first one is the human interface, where you have an avatar talking to you. So that's a virtual personal assistant, chatbots to a certain extent, although they don't have the intelligence behind them. The second type you have is the huge data analysis systems like IBM Watson, and those are able to do predictive analysis on huge amounts of data. And the third type is all that's to do with self-driving cars, digital twins, so you can actually create a digital version of a real object and predict when it's going to fail, for instance. So a lot of the repetitive tasks we do today at work, we will automate them with AI, which will give us the time to concentrate on more interesting jobs with added value. So you're not doing the mundane of repetitive tasks, but you're doing something which you like doing, which brings you pleasure, makes you want to come to work in the morning, and will allow you to give added value to your employer. The first one is a virtual personal assistant, where you can go into a hotel room now and you can talk to different types of objects to allow you to book meals in a restaurant or book a taxi. So it's automatically done. You don't have to phone down to the front desk. Hilton in Washington, who have put a small robot called Now that they call Connie as a concierge, and she is quite capable of answering quite a lot of questions about the hotel and activities around the hotel. The second way is this area of what an experience is and what we can do to tailor make that experience to the person. You may like quiet holidays on a beach, and the system may be able to find you a part of the world you've never seen before, but would be the idyllic place from what you've made on comments on Facebook or Instagram of what you think is the best holiday that you could ever imagine. AI can do that for you today. We need to be aware of what this technology can do, how it's going to change our world, and how we will offer services in the future. And I think it's extremely important that our students are aware of what's coming. They need to know the amount of work that it takes to put one of these systems in place, because also people think today that you buy an AI system out of the box and it can answer every question you've got. It takes a lot of hard work to teach an AI system to do what you want it to do. I relate that to having a baby. You have this baby who knows nothing, and then you have to take the baby and teach it, correct it, show it the right path. And when you've got to a certain age or experience in terms of AI, the AI system will then be able to answer most of the time what you want it to answer. But we're not there yet, and it is not magic. Mm-hmm.